Welcome to the EO Dashboard Hackathon. My name is Han Ho Yun from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory at California Institute of Technology. I'm going to share our story of generating maps of cities around the world showing human activity level changes. And I'm going to challenge you to share your own local stories. This work is being done through a wonderful collaboration with the Earth Observatory of Singapore, and we greatly appreciate ESA and JAXA for sharing their data for this project. We know a significant portion of the Earth is covered with clouds. This is an average cloudiness map based on NASA satellite observations. And half of the world is always dark. Then, what do you think is an ideal sensor to make observations of the Earth's surface, regardless of weather or time of day? We use radar or microwave because it penetrates clouds. Also, we can use it day and night because radar sensors don't need sunlight. Think about GPS, which also uses microwave. When you navigate with GPS, you don't worry about its performance on a cloudy day or when you're driving late at night. But there is an important difference from GPS. We use microwave, but rather than using it for navigation, we use it to produce images. The technology is called synthetic aperture radar, or SAR. I wrote it down as SAR, but let me read it as high resolution imaging radar. Here's how synthetic aperture radar works. A satellite flying in this direction is transmitting radar signals down to the Earth. And some portion of the echo returns right back to the satellite, and we use the recorded echoes. SAR technology involves illuminating each ground object with not just one, but thousands of radar beams. Then we carefully process the multiple echoes to achieve high-resolution images. Here's an example of SAR image being formed. You can see more details showing up in the SAR image as we involve more and more echoes. Using such SAR observations, we developed a suite of different methods to detect significant changes on the ground. One of such products is called Damage Proxy Map that shows locations of building or land damage caused by natural disaster events such as earthquakes, volcanoes, tropical cyclones, tornadoes, landslides, and wildfires. These figures show damage proxy maps of Beirut after the August 2020 explosion and the Bahamas devastated by the Category 5 Hurricane Dorian in 2019. For the past 12 years, we've supported over 100 major disaster response efforts and humanitarian assistance around the world. Then came the COVID-19 pandemic. We shifted our gears and started producing maps of major cities around the world, targeting to detect changes not by natural disasters, but by human activities. We all have gone through COVID-19 lockdown of one kind or another. Depending on the severity, government policies, and culture, the way we responded to pandemic and government's measures were all different. The question is, how effective our reduction of activities was to control the outbreaks of the virus? Did our collective action pay off? If so, how much? In order to answer the question, we first need observations of human activities. Using satellite SAR observations, we made maps of comprehensive, consistent, and quantitative information that may indicate the human activity level changes. We call these maps slowdown proxy map in blue pixels on the left, and recovery proxy map in yellow pixels on the right. This is an area near the Disneyland in Los Angeles. The slowdown proxy map was produced by comparing SAR observations of April 2020 during the lockdown with January to February 2020 before lockdown. The recovery proxy map was produced by comparing observations of June 2020 with April 2020. You can see clear reduction of activities in the Disneyland parking lots here and here and here, as well as other business in this area, like this one and this one. But by the time of June 2020, you can also see that only few businesses show the sign of recovery or increased level of activities. Each pixel here measures about 30 by 30 meters. We generated such maps of 120 cities in the world. Mostly, we used the SAR data from the Copernicus Sentinel-1 satellites operated by ESA. We also used JAXA's ALOS-2 SAR data for a limited number of cities. This turned out to be an enormous data set, 120 cities at every 30 meters. It's impossible for us to look at every corner of the street. So I'd like to challenge you to look at the maps of your area and share your own local knowledge. For a limited number of cities, we have seen that the signals in our maps correlate with different arrangement of cars in parking lots, construction site slowdown and recovery, traffic volume in certain cases on the road, airport, harbor, and railways. And I'm sure there are so many other signals we have not looked at. Do you know of any significant change in human activities in your area? Do you have any economic records or indicators of your city that you want to compare with radar observations? Or do you have any stories of your business, town, or society that are relevant to what you see on the slowdown or recovery proxy maps? Then please send me an email and share your local knowledge, data, and stories. Let's connect and work together.